Hello, I'm Michael Gross, host of the B&O Railroad Museum Television Network. This is the Allegheny-type locomotive, Chesapeake and Ohio, number 1604, the largest, most powerful steam locomotive on exhibit at the B&O Railroad Museum. This monster machine was designed to haul a 5,000-ton freight train at 45 miles per hour.
Designed by the Lima Locomotive Works, the Chesapeake and Ohio Railroad's 2666 Class H8 Allegheny locomotives were the most powerful reciprocating steam locomotives to be built anywhere in the world. While most of American industry was in a terrible economic slump during the 1930s, the C&O was busy constructing new tunnels, laying double track, rebuilding bridges, and generally upgrading their railroad system. This fortuitous situation was due to the main product they transported, coal. Some of the finest bituminous coal deposits in America were adjacent to the C&O routes, and coal was needed even during a poor economic climate. It became evident that the C&O would need additional motive power for the 80-mile coal run between Hinton, West Virginia, and Clifton Forge, Virginia, a route that crossed the Allegheny Mountains and included a 0.58% 13-mile grade up to a 2,072-foot summit and a descent of 1.14% into Clifton Forge. Severe grades and extremely heavy freight required locomotives with unprecedented power. This new locomotive, named in honor of the Allegheny Mountain Range it traveled, weighed over 775,000 pounds and used four 22.5-inch diameter cylinders with a 33-inch stroke. The articulated chassis carried a huge boiler with a 9-foot by 15-foot firebox, containing a 135-square-foot grate. The resulting rear weight required a 6-wheel trailer truck to support it. The tender was the largest ever designed for the C&O, weighing over 430,000 pounds and contained a 25,000-gallon water tank and a 25-ton coal bunker. The length of the locomotive and tender was limited by the length of existing roundhouse turntables, so the tender was designed to be short and its rear section was designed high to carry a lot of weight. This configuration required an 8-wheel rear tender truck to distribute the load to the rails. Slightly over 124 feet, the length of the locomotive and tender proved to be one of the finest locomotive designs in American railroad history. The first Allegheny locomotive was built in 1941. How many years did they run before being replaced by diesel locomotives? We'll find out after this. Stay tuned for information on upcoming events at the B&O Railroad Museum.
Toddler Time Halloween Celebration and Costume Parade. Join us for this year's Last Toddler Time, featuring a classic railroad story and Halloween celebration. Children parade in costume around the museum campus to collect special treats. Children may take a train ride through Choo Choo Blueville, all included with paid admission. Recommended for ages 2 to 5. Railfest Steam Days Weekend. Take a steam train ride behind the St. Elizabeth and watch a steam demonstration by the oldest operating steam engine in America, the William Mason. Join us for this weekend devoted to steam power as we let off a lot of steam.
Better still, just stop the train because I want to look around.
In December 1941, the first 10 locomotives produced were immediately pressed into service to meet the demands of World War II. The performance of the Allegheny was so impressive that the C&O ordered an additional 10 locomotives. During the war, the C&O had 23 of its Allegheny-class locomotives modified to include steam heating and signal lines for passenger service, but used them only rarely to haul a troop train or heavy mail train. Their more normal assignment was to haul a 10,000-ton freight train at 15 miles per hour. This is in stark contrast to their design goal of hauling a 5,000-ton train at 45 miles per hour. Thus, the Allegheny locomotives were never given the opportunity to demonstrate their full potential. Only 11 years later, in 1952, the 60 Alleghenies on the C&O roster were replaced by diesel locomotives. Only two Allegheny locomotives survived and are on public display today in the United States. Number 1601 is at the Henry Ford Museum in Dearborn, Michigan. Number 1604 is here at the B&O Railroad Museum in Baltimore, Maryland.
Plan a visit to the B&O Railroad Museum where you can climb into the cab of the Allegheny and imagine what it was like to be the engineer. I'm Michael Gross, and thanks for watching the B&O Railroad Museum Television Network.
Interested in learning more about the B&O Railroad Museum in Ellicott City Station? Follow us on Facebook and Twitter with daily updates on upcoming events, coupons, photographs, history, and things to do in Baltimore. You'll never be off track.